Hello there, everyone! This is your robotic lord, Iron Mark III, welcoming you back to Codex of Victory! And my Chamber of Justice with my utilitarian throne, which shows I am a man of the people! Machine of the people! Yes! You control me, not the other way around. Last time, I defeated the Baron's treacherous attempts to locate and assault my base. And now I know where to visit him. It is time to say hello to my good neighbour, bringing lots and lots of cake and cookies. And, of course, high explosives, the greatest of delicacies. Yeah, welcome back, everyone. Okay, there's not really much to say beyond that, beyond all that intro stuff, because research is still going. I'm okay with the workshop, as you saw at the end of last time. I'm building a couple of spare jeeps to go into my slots because I had two free capacity up there, but yeah. Apart from that, I am actually ready to roll immediately, so that time that I spent upgrading my vehicles and things between last episode and the episode before it really helped out, but it's time to go to this place. So, roll time on. Oop, something happened. Oh, the factory's finished. Right. Okay, here we go. Important key mission. The boar. It is time to visit my good friend and ally, Baron Borov. Destroy Baron Borov's better armor. What? Ooh, shiny. Okay, let's take a quick... Ooh, there's something else. What the... Okay, this is going to be interesting, I think. Right, he's got scorpion tanks. He's got X-Line battle armor, a new experimental variant of the battle armor, available only to ace pilots. Features jump jets that let him jump over rivers and rocks. I've not actually faced a river yet, so I'm guessing that's a new terrain feature. Got combat drones, turrets, attack choppers, crab tanks... Lovely, lovely little crab tanks. I'm actually working on building one of those. But yeah, anyway, moving on. This thing is... Tank 8. Oh, it's the heavy tank. The heavy tank that I had right at the start, and then I've not had since. Oh. So I was an ace tanker before I became a lord, apparently. Then there's artillery, support choppers, and... Baron Borov himself. Huge walking battle robot armed with projectiles, rocket launchers, and heavy armor. I get the feeling I should have tried to cram a targeting drone into my force before this, but anyway. Right, intro time. Mission description. Important key mission, the boar. We've got the coordinates of Borov's residence and should be ready to pay him a visit with milk and cookies, of course. The Baron is gathering all his troops in the area, so the battle will be the hardest so far. On the other hand, you can be sure the Baron will be on the battlefield. He can't back out after what he said on the broadcast channel, otherwise he will be killed by his own army. So if I don't attack him, then he'll get killed by his own army? Why am I attacking? Oh, whatever. Let's go and say hello. At least this time I'll be able to deploy all of my stuff instead of just that rather sharp limit that I ran into in the previous battle. I didn't know that that was how it was going to do it. And since I had to attempt the mission twice, I did struggle a bit because my units were a bit on the expensive side. My current forces are flat out better. Oh, wow. This is actually a big place. Ooh. Oh. Hello, Baron. 60 hit points, what? I really wish I'd brought a targeting drone with me. Bird needs must and all that. Attack range of 2. At least he doesn't have jump jets, so there is that. Anyway, he's got a lot of stuff on the field. I think I want to try and push him back, roll his forces back to that choke point and take that with my tanks. Because my tanks are tough as hell. That'd be a good idea. I've also got a load of these guys all around me. That's not good. But I think they're in artillery range. So, I need artillery. Let's see. Roughly 1, 2, 3, 4... Yeah, my artillery should be able to hit that tank from here. And they deal 5 damage each, so 2 artillery pieces can knock out one of those tanks, no problem. I'm glad I've got heavy artillery pieces. Yep, those two can do that. That guy will move in and try to kill my artillery, without doubt. I need to spend my remaining points. So I'll put a jeep in as well, and then that's it. I still kind of miss having jeeps with 1 AP cost. Anyway, that's me. Ready. I should be able to... Yep, he's in range. I can knock him straight out. I've got 6 points. 4 points if I count the artillery firing. That means I need to put some stuff in to delay these guys. They'll deal 8 damage total. And I can only deploy for 4 points worth of stuff. So, let's put down a couple more jeeps. There we go. So I've got a bunch of light blockers available. My artillery deal with that guy. Straight out. Oh, I forgot. I should have moved those two jeeps up. I'm going to lose an artillery piece. I'll be okay, though. I've got plenty left. Yep, there goes the artillery. Kind of sucks, but hey, whatever. I've got another 5 points, but... Actually, can I do that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, I don't have enough to do it that way. I need an additional... I can't deploy an additional artillery piece. Oh dear. I might be about to lose my other artillery piece, actually. I need to lock that tank down with the zone of control so it can't move up and do that. So, hit it. Then lock it down. So it can't really get past. And then these jeeps will just roll up here because I need more points. Yeah, there. So that's going to survive. I don't think it can hit my... Wait, if it moves there... No, it can't. I think that tank's locked down unless it can ignore zone of control. I don't think it can. No, it can't. It's got forest walk. Okay. My artillery will be fine. So they're going to focus on that jeep. Another sacrifice there. I thought that was going to happen. And, oh dear. Hello, Scorpion. Right, okay. I've got 6 points available. What can I say? I need something to start dealing more damage. I want another artillery, but I can't. I want a tank, but I can't. Actually, a tank will be fine. Yeah, let's get something heavy. One of my heavier blocking units in. And then just knock that tank straight out, so that's fine. Okay. They focused on that. Right. Oh, jeez. This might be a problem, actually. My tank can't stand that much firepower in one go. But I can knock out one of those tanks immediately. If I deploy an additional artillery piece. Oh, no, I can't. Blast it. I'm going to lose that artillery. Well, this is going swimmingly. Yep, there goes the artillery. Grab tanks are moving up to knock out other stuff. And I'm getting pinned straight into my starting area. My current composition really, really does struggle with early deployment cost. 5, 6, 7, 8. If I can survive the early rounds of a match, I can get more powerful and get more stuff involved. I've only got one more spare artillery piece, so I don't want to deploy that. Ideally, I want to actually move the artillery piece back. I've got plenty of jeeps, though, so do that. Oh, yes, Ward, of course. Frig. I forgot it had a ward on it. Move that in so that they get locked down a bit, and then might as well just chip at that. I get the feeling I'm going to lose this one on the initial contact again. I'm going to lose that tank. Though they wasted their shots for the most part. Yep, that's all down. Okay. Another... Yeah, they're just pinning me in now. got 9 points, though. Oh, that's interesting. Does that mean that ward has actually been depleted? I better attack it and find out. Okay, ward only works once, I think. Or it's got a recharge time. One or the other. Can't tell which. But if I put that into here, then I can start to fire at full effect. I'm almost certain to lose this artillery piece. But I can knock that tank straight out. I can knock the scorpion tank straight out. And I can't maneuver the artillery far enough to avoid that. So, that's it. That artillery is about to die as well. That's the other drawback of this unit composition I've got. Yep, there it goes. I'm highly reliant on those artillery pieces, but they are incredibly fragile because of how I've tuned them, so... Yeah, I really need my last artillery piece to safely knock out these guns. But I need to deal with the stuff that's harassing me right now as well. I can attack 2 range on those, can't I? Yes, I can. So really, I need my core tanks right now. There we go. 2 drones down. That leaves their primary walker. But 2 tanks should be able to safeguard some artillery. I shouldn't have deployed so much artillery from the start, but that's neither here nor there. I don't want to deploy anything else right now, so 2 tanks. I think that tank, yeah, it took a cheeky pot shot at my aircraft, so. Oh god, they've got a chopper. I'm going to lose this, I think. Yeah, I think I'm going to lose this. Let's get the artillery piece out. So, okay, let's see. I want the artillery to open up. Actually. There we go. That's the tanks dealt with, but there is still that thing over there. That's going to wander in. But I've got enough power now to actually deal with it. Thanks to the AP steadily increasing AP on my side. General damage, that's not going to do you much good. Oh! Jeez. Here comes an advanced mech. Lovely. Right. What's the range on those? They've got counterattack, but they can't counterattack artillery outside the range. Range of 3. Thought so, right. This front row of my place is safe. I need to move this one forward to hit them. So, let's do that. Get you out of the way. And then casually knock that down. There goes the chopper. That big mech's going to walk in, but my tank's going to hold the line, I think. Unless it's got a rocket attack. I don't think it does, actually. Wait, yes, it does. It's got lion strike, distance 4, so that could actually knock out my artillery piece quite easily. Lovely! Artillery is my key unit, after all, so I don't want them to do that. Oh, well, at least I've got my tanks. They're heading pretty tough. And he... Why did he do that? Why did he knock out that, of all things? I don't know. Because now I can just knock him out straight out. That tank there will be in reach, so... Actually, it's better to be there. Move that forward. Okay. I guess this is where I'm going to learn if... he gets infinite units or not. Because if he does, he'll just keep deploying lots and lots of random stuff. If he doesn't... Oh, interesting. Okay. I think he doesn't get infinite units. He has a limit like I do. Okay, so that's a hit. If I move this guy forward, though, he'll take 12 damage and I'll lose him immediately. I've got to use the artillery pieces to knock this stuff out. because it would counterattack and then all three turrets could hit it as well because they've got longer range. So yeah, got to use the artillery pieces. So it's time to bring in the Scorpion tank. I should have done that first, actually. Oh well. And I might as well bring in an extra jeep too. And again, no units. Okay. I really do think that the enemy doesn't have spare units around. Okay. Let's move in. Let's just start moving up. I don't care about getting hit by that thing again. And that match started out as a mess. I've got to keep these jeeps out of range, though. They can't heal. Which is a slight oversight on my part, but they can't heal. Oh no, my tank got damaged. Whatever will I do? I'll just let it heal. So, yeah. Okay, this artillery piece can move there. I seem to have won by attrition more than anything else. And, oh bugger, that's in range for a retaliation strike. That means I need to use the tanks. Yep, counter. Fire again, dead. G, capture. I'm probably close enough to trigger these units to counter-attack that jeep, actually, so that might be a bad thing. But I forgot that this thing is actually really darn slow. Yep, here comes the ace tank. Missile strike. Oh, bugger. My artillery got dead. Some of my jeeps got slightly dinged as well, but that's not too bad. My main problem, though, is the artillery piece got knocked out. And I'm out of those. So there's no... my tactics fail! I'm too reliant on the artillery pieces. I've realised that now. But, yeah. Okay. I really need to lead with the tanks. How far can this one move? Not far. Right. Can't really move that close enough to do anything. Yeah, so the jeeps need to take cover. The tanks are rolling up to take the brunt of it. Yep, can fire past that. Bigots, but not much to be done about it. So. He's got 9 hit points, though. I love that. This Scorpion tank's got flamethrowers on it. Dead. Right. That thing is sitting there, can deal 4 damage per turn. It's got support, so it can counter, so it needs to be killed first, ideally. Can move 4. Oh, that's interesting. I can see how far they can move. I didn't realise. That could move there and attack there. So, I need to move that tank to there, and it'll be safe. Yeah, that tank will be safe there. That's up. So anything up north? There's another scorpion and thing, but I don't need those. So yeah. Interesting. Very interesting. I didn't know that. Good to know. Yep, that's moving up to try and fire. Figured it would. But now it's in rushing range of my tanks, so I can knock it straight out. Yep, that's all fine. I want to be careful with my Scorpion tank, actually. But no, wait, I gave it some regeneration, so it can take a few hits. That's fine. Just the jeeps I need to be careful of. I'll need to preserve them for last attack. But I can get more tanks in. Hmm. Tempting. I should get the attack chopper in, though. Yeah. Just start spending all these points I've got to get more units. Should I call him my last jeep? Might as well, yep. What the? Ow! That's ridiculous, that. Okay, so you have missile launch distance 20. What? 20? I want one. I really, really want one, but you killed a tank. How dare you? Right, I can get a jeep over there to grab some more points. That should be okay. Unless it triggers that bot up in the next one. It might. Oh well, I'll have to deal with that when I get to it. So, that thing can pick off... The bound can pick off my units at will, basically. So I need to be careful with that. But I've got tanks to spare. Oh yeah, the war. That's fine. Might as well send in my damage jeep. Say hello. I'm doing this out of order. I'm not used to having a scorpion tank around to buff things. Go, dead. Grab the point, so I can't spawn anything behind me. And keep moving up. And I've got enough forces out now that I can actually spend all my AP on it. Okay. Here comes the spider. Bring it. No missile barrage, so that tank's going to live. Because it can tank that much, no problem. I do love these tanks, though. My army composition may be slightly off. But... I've got a great combination of units around that I can use. My tanks are superb. I think they're the best unit I've got, really, because of how I've tuned them. So they can just take so much punishment. And they just shrug off 4 points every turn in regeneration as well. That is very powerful. 5 points left, I can move up. The good news is that guy didn't trigger, so I don't have to worry about him at all. And I just need to move up my jeeps. So, jeep up. Keep on pushing, and this is my armoured column. Okay. That's all this has turned into. Nope, here comes the missile strike. There's nothing else in range to exploit that, though, I think. So, yeah. He went for one of my jeeps. That's fine, I expect him to do that. I knew I was going to lose the jeeps pushing forward, but he's got that flipping 60 health I needed to be wary of as well. Now then, my plan is to capture these 2 points, and then I'll put down turrets, so that'll help, in general. Because they can fire further than my tanks can. Keep on pushing. The jeeps are going to be picked off one by one, I feel. Because they can't restore themselves. Can I bring in something else? I could bring in an additional tank. I could put it in there, but then that'll take turns to move up, so that's not much point. And I don't want to bring in my lord, because he'll just get hit by the rockets. Oh. What's this? Oh, poor Baron. Now, what was his voice? Oh, yes.
All units, attack the enemy! All divisions, attack! Don't stand around like sheep!
That means the other stuff's going to be coming my way. Yep. Oh, he's coming to me! You idiot! You idiot! I've cleared... good thing I took out that heavy tank. That's going to be a pain. But, yeah. You, sir, are a huge idiot for doing that. You've also got ward, apparently. Put turret in there. Because I've got a flipping choke point on you over here, you know? Let's see. I want to move out this jeep, actually. It's so weak it'll die anyway, so I might as well use it to hit that scorpion and chip away its ward. So there we go. Move that into there. So the turrets are getting boosted. I want to chip away that guy's ward as well so that my true attacks can start hitting him. So I'll sacrifice my other damaged jeep for that purpose. Roll it forward, hit it. Bye-bye to that ward. Tank there, defensive positions. Attack chopper, hang back a little bit because that's going to cost me to do something. Deploy an additional turret. Deploy an additional tank, And deploying in... No, I want to hang on to a turret. Actually, I want to turret there. I got that backwards. Like, I really wish I still had that artillery. But I don't, so, yeah. Okay. He's moving. Oh, the fool! Oh! Ow! What?! Ouch! Oh, that, there goes that jeep. Oh, here comes the big mech. Yep. Here comes the rest of the stuff. Yeah. This is going about as well as I expected. That's fine. My tanks and things are all in place, so... What's my weakest thing? I can't get anything close enough to hit that scorpion behind the big guy, though, so that's an issue. He's got a lot of firepower. If I had a targeting drone, I could do so much damage to him so fast, but I can't. Need to move that tank forward. Pull in an additional turret there. All my turrets are in range of him, so it's up to be him. I can knock out that... I can knock that straight out, actually. So it behooves me to do so. You can just use my jeep for that. Bye-bye to that guy. So that's that flank more or less secured. And I need to just focus on hitting him. I could bring in an additional tank, but I've got all these turrets ready to go. Yeah, I just knocked 15 straight off him. I want that scorpion to stay there, because that's boosting all of my turrets up. But... I can block him on the bridge with an additional tank. Yeah, that sounds good. Back of tank. Move in. Barricade! Ha! Suck it. Oh yeah, that guy's jump jetting around the place. Oop, ow. Focusing fire on one of my tanks. Yeah, combined they can do that. So, I do need to actually focus fire on reducing their damage potential. Otherwise, I'm definitely going to lose this. But that's okay, that's about what I figured was going to happen. Now then, I need to knock that guy out. So... I need multiple tank hits to do it. But I need points for the firing of the rest of my stuff, though. His ward's come back up. So the ward does come back. Okay, good to know. Okay, the jeep can get into reach. Okay. They can't quite do enough, so the turret will deal with it. He'll fire to knock the ward out. And then the other turrets will just open up on him. Knocking him down even further. His repair chopper's coming into reach, though, so that's pretty close. Get a jeep. Sorry, a tank. There we go. Yep, he moves forward. Idiot. They're going to kill that tank now. But he's out of reach of his support, so... Okay. What an idiot. Moving straight into the thick of things like that. Anyway, my jeep is somehow alive. So... That means I can pop that ward. I can fire straight away on this guy. Six. Two tanks. That he's got. Right. And that thing's only got six health, so I can knock it straight out with a couple of turret strikes. That guy goes. Bye-bye. You're all alone now, your barren ship. And so everything else just unload into him. This choke point's actually worked really well. And since he's moved forward, I can put in my last turret over there. And that can fire at him as well. Ha-ha! I will claim victory! Hey, you blew up my turret, how dare you? I don't really care, because they're incredibly cheap. At this rate, I'm going to actually deploy my lord as well. But I don't think I need to, I can just knock him straight out. And that guy's just hanging around like livestock. Despite the Baron's orders, so I don't care. Fire, fire, fire! All piling on him. And there he goes. By a jeep. Oh, that's got to sting. Anyway. Voice time. And this will be the end of the episode. Because it has worked out again at one match in the video.
pleased with the victory? It will be short-lived. I just sent all the passcodes for the Star System's defences to the Augment. They contacted me recently and offered help. I have a scan of my brain transferred to their computer. I have a sensor chip in my head, and my digital copy will activate immediately after my death, which will be now. I'm not going to rot in the King's dungeons.
Oh, you swine. Digital immortality. Gunshot sound. Right. And down he goes. Splat. Flat on his face. Yeah, wild swine. I called him a swine and he is. Right. Jeez. I got a bunch of credits, bunch of materials. Got a spare artillery piece. I lost like five or so in this. And a laboratory blueprint. Laboratory blueprint, sure. Laboratory blueprint. I don't know. But I've lost a few units, that's for sure. I can confirm what the Baron said. We cannot establish a connection with any other planets in our star system, even from Borov's residence. Most of the star defense systems are offline and dead. Lord Ironmockery, you have been entrusted with a great mission to protect the three inhabited planets of your star system from the Augment invasion. Now I'm going back to the capital and we'll try to ensure you receive all the help and assistance you need. Well, I managed to take this part back and I've saved his life, so you know, it's doing okay. I have found the cause of our technical difficulties. All our data comes through communications node on Elonia. Its systems were hacked and apparently it has been controlled by the enemy for a long time. Lovely. We need to regain control of this communication center as soon as possible. Or else, given time, our enemies could use it to hack the whole planetary defense system. Your Lordship, please be aware that there is no atmosphere on Elonia. As a result, all our flying units will be useless there. Also, good news for you. We found a new custom-built battle armor in the Baron's residence. It has the same controls as yours, but performs better. I'll get it ready for your next battle. So, I have an upgrade to the base! No, it's the same. It's the same. How dare you! You led me to believe my robotic chassis would be empowered, but it looks the same, so... Out the airlock with all of you. Okay, the star map. And that planet's still locked, so my next wars will be on this world. Which I have to do in the next 4 days. The Sands of Freedom. The Hacker. The enemy has gained control of the communication center of Elonia. We have to find the source of the attack and regain control of the center. Why am I reading this? I should be reading this in the next video. Never mind. To base. Nothing's ready. That's still digging out, so I can't build there yet. Thank you very much. So, yeah. New laboratory one. New room is available. I'm going to stick it somewhere around here, I think. But that is also it for this episode. It's just past the 30-minute mark. Since I took a bit of a hammering there and lost over half my forces, I'm going to pause again and rebuild before the next video. So, outro time. This has been the Robotic Lord, Ironmark 3, leading the people to a great and plentiful existence. I hope you have been pleased to witness my exploits in this endeavor, and I hope to see you some other time if I deign to notice your no doubt worthwhile existences in my domain. See you all later, perhaps. Yeah, see you later, everyone. End of video.